It's not Revelation, they messed it up. So, Revelation is coming to you to give you some revelation today. So, make sure you got your Bibles. I might have to slap you in the face with it or whatever, but that is my name. Get it right, get it straight, get it together, because this granny is coming with some revelation for you today.
No matter what I tell myself, baby.
Y'all hear that?
Never thought I'd ever love.
Oh yes, we're vibing. I'm vibing today. Got some good old music. Y'all know nothing about that. Yes. Hallelujah.
And I think about the day
you. Alright, let me turn this off now, y'all. Hold on. Miss Reba was vibing. Miss Reba was vibing.
I think about it.
Give me a second, y'all. Hey, how y'all doing today? I know I haven't been around in a while. You know, Miss Reba, she's been taking a break. I've been having some things going on. You know, my husband, Jerry Curl, get a curl, got a curl. I don't know what to call him, but my husband, Jerry, he been doing so much. Like, he went on an airplane. That man don't even like airplane. He went on an airplane to see his friend. And he been taking me hiking up mountains and stuff. He just been doing too much. So, Miss Reba, she had to take a break. She had to take a break. With too much going on. My blood pressure was getting high. Mm-mm. That's too much for an old woman like me. But anyways, y'all. Hey, how y'all doing? It's Miss Reba. This is Revelation with Reba LaShawn. I'm Reba LaShawn. If y'all don't know now, you know I'm Miss Reba LaShawn. And you know Miss Reba LaShawn, she don't play. She don't play. And she got something to come to y'all about today. Now, today's topic with Revelation with Reba LaShawn, Miss Reba LaShawn, me, the Granny with Style. Yes, I am the Granny with Style. We are going to talk about stealing. Now, we know that you ain't supposed to steal. That is a commandment. That commandment says, thou shalt not steal. Or Miss Reba has a right to kill. Now, that's not what this commandment say. I'm just playing. But really, we not supposed to be going around stealing from nobody. And y'all know that. Now, the other day, y'all know Miss Reba. Every time y'all see me, I'm up in my car. Because Miss Reba be having a whole bunch of runs to make. You know, I always be at the supermarket and everything. So the other day, I was up in the supermarket just shopping around, getting me some bread, some eggs, you know, getting me some stuff. I was getting me some stuff. And it was this little boy. He was about probably 12 years old. And this boy, he was just grabbing stuff, putting stuff up in his pockets. This boy was just a stealing. Now, we know that this boy, he was like 12 years old. He is not at that age of innocence no more. So he knew perfectly well what he was doing. It's not like when you take one of your, you know, I got great grands. I'm a great granny. I'm so great. But anyway, I got great grandkids. And it's not like when your great grandkids, they come up to the supermarket with you. You know, they're like 3 years old and they just start stuffing stuff in their pocket. And all of a sudden you see them eating on something. And you like, boy, what is you eating? And they just stick their tongue out. And they got all kind of Skittles, M&M's, everything up in their mouth. No, this was one of them situations. Boy was like 12 years old. And he got the nerve to just be stuffing stuff up in his backpack. Let me tell you. Miss Reba, I didn't have my Bible with me. Otherwise, I would have bopped him upside the head. Because he know perfectly well he not supposed to be doing that. So, let me tell y'all something. If y'all want to get into the kingdom of God, the kingdom of Yahweh, if y'all want to make it into the kingdom amongst Jesus and sit up at his feet and just praise him, worship him, and have a good old time, then you cannot be going up in supermarkets stealing. This not no supermarket shuffle. You're not about to be shuffling out the store with a whole bunch of stuff up in your pocket or your backpack. That's just not how it works. Now, if Miss Reva see it, and I got my pretty pink Bible, I will bop you upside the head with it. This little gang-banging kid, I don't even know what he was doing, but we don't know his situation. You know, maybe he was starving, maybe he had some stuff going on, but all I know is the boy was stealing. And you know, Miss Reva don't like to be in situations like that, because we didn't know if the boy was crazy. What if they would have chased the boy down and he had a gun or something? Miss Reva is not trying to be up in that situation, because somebody pull out a gun, I am gonna pull out my weapon too, my Bible, because I ain't got no weapon. That's the only weapon I got, and that weapon is gonna protect me against anything. That weapon could be a weapon, you know, because I didn't bop so many people upside the head with that Bible. So it's better weapon than any gun, any knife, any taser, anything. That word of God, that's gonna get you some places, okay? So yes, Miss Reva was up in that crazy situation. People want to steal and put Miss Reva life in danger. Now let me give y'all some Bible to back this up. Y'all know I gotta give y'all the Bible. Yes, grab this pretty pink Bible. Okay, so Exodus 20:15 simply says, thou shalt not steal. That's Exodus 20:15. Not exorcist. Okay? Not excellent. Exodus 20:15. And we ain't talking about the year 2015. Yes, the year 2015, that was a great year. I don't even want to reflect. Oh, Lord, I did some things up in 2015. But no. Exodus chapter 20, verse 15 says, thou shalt not steal. Okay? Now, let's also turn to John chapter 10:10. Okay? Now John 10:10 says, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill. See what happens when people steal? Turns into killing. You know, somebody go up in there and they steal in the store and they have a gun, and then it turns from stealing to killing. That's just Miss Reva don't want to be in that situation. And to destroy. Now, I definitely don't want to be destroyed. I still got many years before me, okay? I may be old, but honey, Miss Reva can still shake this rump. I still got many years ahead of me. I am come that they might have life. Life. And that they might have it more abundantly. See, I'm trying to tell y'all, this Bible is truth. Now, Ms. Reva, she loves this Bible. This Bible right here, this pretty pink Bible, this is my best friend. Mm-hmm. Because anything you need to find is up in this Bible. Anything that's going on up in the world today is up in this Bible. Now, I'm going to bring one more scripture to y'all. The last scriptures that I have is 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 through 10. And it says, know ye not that unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate. I don't even know. Ooh, Jesus. What kind of words is these? Is this Webster's dictionary, Urban Dictionary? What kind of dictionary is this? Nor abusers of themselves with mankind. Nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor drunkards. Who is really used to turn up when I was young? Oh, I'm sorry. Let me get back to this. Nor rivalers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. Do you want to inherit the kingdom of God? Do you really want to inherit the kingdom of God? Because you definitely not going to inherit that kingdom if you steal it. Now, let Miss Reva tell you something. Let me tell you something. All these drunkards, all these smokers, I guess that's what you call them, all of these stealers, all of these beaters, all of these people, they're not going to inherit the kingdom of God. God don't want people like that up in his kingdom. Now, I'm not playing with y'all. The next time I see somebody come up in the supermarket that I'm at and steal something, y'all remember when I talked to y'all about beating little Billy with a Bible? Let me tell you. You see the pop right here? They gonna have it right upside their head. Because Miss Reba don't play that. I'm not gonna play with my life, honey. I got a whole lot of life to live. 2,072 more years I got. And I'm not gonna play with my life. So, thou shalt not steal, especially when Miss Reba is in the supermarket. Do not steal when Miss Reba is in the supermarket. Because when I feel like my life is in danger, I will put yours in danger. I will call on the Lord and I will be like, Lord, forgive me, for they know not what I'm about to do. That's plain and simple. This is a simple thing that I wanted to come to y'all about. I just wanted to give y'all a little short teaching. Nothing crazy. Miss Reba just wanted to say hello. I'm still here. I'm still that crazy granny. I just been taking a vacation, a sleepcation, a relaxationcation, and my husband, Jerry Curl, get a curl. Jerry Curl got a curl. Jerry Curl with a curl. He been working my nerve. Like always, ain't nothing changed. But Miss Reba, love y'all. This has been Revelation with Reba LeShine. I hope y'all have a wonderful, fabulous, incredible, wonderful, amazing, hallelujah time today. And I will talk to y'all soon. Please continue to stay in y'all Bibles, stay on y'all knees, and just stay close to the Lord, because Miss Reba wants to see y'all when I make it to that kingdom. Hallelujah. All right, y'all. I'll talk to y'all soon. Get back to my song. Y'all jamming. Oh, yes. Oh. Yes, Kim. See that.
Think about us, girl. Yeah. There will be no more lies.